baling war engine. The first day it has been out of the shop. Put it on the cart down there, and what I have just done just now, put the decal on the cart, put the muffler on, painted it with a high temperature black paint. That's the only painted part on the engine, is the muffler system. Built a new spark plug wire, installed a Essex larger pipe fitting down there. 3/8 pipe, what that is. Nice evening here on the East Coast of Arkansas. Got them there cicadas, them locusts is out of singing this evening. The engine is dry. The next thing to do is to put the magneto on it. But first, what I need to do is to set these gib keys tight. And I don't want to tighten them completely up, but I want to tighten them to a safe position. And I've got the flywheels. If you remember on the workbench in there, we centered that crankshaft up in there. And the way to do them gib keys there is a brass drift punch, medium-sized hammer. And you come on this side of the engine right here, and either one, push the flywheels in the opposite direction. With that pressure there, and then reach over, knock that flywheel tight, the gib key right there, set it tight, and then you come around and do the same thing on the other side. Hold the flywheel that way, and that's all I'm going to tighten them right now, because I kind of feel like it's standard practice to run the engine, a couple of tanks of fuel, let's say, and then you probably will need to tighten those up a little bit after they wear into, the surfaces that way, and even take a shim or two out. But that's plenty tight on the gib keys to run it in a couple of tanks of fuel. Now, let's put that magneto on there. Boil linseed oil on all of the bare metal parts. This one does have the cover on it that does not have the stop button on it. And to put that on there, you just put it right down in there, and that pin has been set tight. Put that right down in there like that. Put it in that bottom hole, twist it around. And if it don't fall in, to move your flywheels to where it'll fall in. That one went right up in there. And tighten, it's only one bolt that holds it on there. We'll tighten that up. Now remember, this is one of the magnetos that we, let's get them fingerprints off of there. Shine her up as you go. The magneto is now installed. To test it on the engine to see if we got a spark, I could remove the spark plug, put the spark plug wire here, put the spark plug up here, and test it that way. But a real quick, easy, if you remember, quick, easy visual test is this light right here. Put that right up there. And this is a metal thing sticking down right there. And I can bend this to sufficiently a spring action that grounds it out. And right in there is where that we will see the spark. Let's give her. And the lever is actually down on the run position now. You see a spark? Okay. Let's get us a close-up on that. And we've got a spark.